Ford Sierra XR4i. Although actually it's not, it's the Merkur XR4Ti here in America. Now unfortunately, and I'm a little bit gutted, this hasn't been touched by Cosworth, but it's still an incredibly rare car in its own right. And it's a car of my generation. I grew up around the Ford Sierra. And like a lot of British people, Americans like to modify their Ford Sierra as well. And that's exactly what somebody's done with this. They've stuck in an aftermarket intercooler. Now, the UK XR4i was fitted with the German-built 2.8-litre V6 Cologne engine. This car, however, was built with a 2.3 Lima engine. Now, interestingly, that exact same engine with an intercooler was also fitted in the 1984-86 Ford Mustang SVO. That stands for Special Vehicle Operations, kind of the fancy arm of Ford Motor Company. And what I reckon happened is somebody's seen that engine with an intercooler in that car and they've simply ripped off the idea. Now, the intercooler's job is simple. It's to put cooler air into the engine. And the reason that's a benefit is because cooler air is slightly higher pressure, and higher pressure air is jam-packed with even more oxygen molecules. And that's it. It's simple. Now, air enters as normal via this air intake. It then goes down to the turbo, where the turbo spins up, pressurizes that air, making it high pressure. It then takes the short journey from the turbo to the intake here. Now, the problem is that somebody's fitted all these gubbins, so instead of taking the direct journey, it now goes via this pipe down to this radiator. Although technically it's not a radiator, it's an intercooler because it's dry inside there. It then cools the air down, sends it back via an even longer series of pipes into the intake. And if you think about it, this should be win-win because you've got high-pressure air, now colder, entering the engine. But the problem with this setup is the volume. This contributes to turbo lag. On top of that, this work has been done really badly. It's all very wobbly. And Mike's point is this also sacrifices the space needed for the air conditioning system. I mean, look at that. That's a lot of real estate inside an engine bay. And to add insult to injury, whoever fitted this intercooler did it with cable ties. And this is the intercooler. And what's great about this project is Mike's managed to buy a car with a boot full of bits. And I've noticed earlier this little puppy here. Now, this is the original item that joins the turbo to the inlet, transferring all that lovely compressed air. Now, you'll notice that it's made of aluminium, a metal that's really good at dissipating heat. And then on top of that, it's got all these extra fins increasing the surface area, making it even better at getting rid of heat. But what I notice the most is the size. See, this is what, 7-8 inches compared to the pipes? About 4 feet, and that's only one half of it. Fitting the original item, it's just simpler. I've got hold of a bit of silicone hose. Connect the silicone hose to the throttle body and the fins connected to the manifold. A couple of hose clamps and tighten it down. There we have it, a direct line from the turbo straight into the inlet. And yes, we lose the cooling element, but this is exactly how the factory intended it. And on top of that, it's left up all this free space for the air conditioning, which is in the boot. Now, having a boot full of parts can be seen as either a good or a bad thing. On one hand, you've got access to the parts you need for the car, but on the other hand, those parts might be broken. After all, they're in the boot for a reason. And that applies to this, the air conditioning compressor. And straight away, I can see that the clutch is missing.
Now, this is the air conditioning compressor off our Merkur. Now, this was just dumped in the boot of the car. The clutch is missing. I don't know if it works. And most people would simply throw this away, go on the internet, click a mouse and buy a new one. But not me. I want to see if I can save the original part and build it back up again. So I've come down to see my friend Mike, who reckons he can help me.
So here we go, Mike. This is the compressor I was telling you about.
We can check the coil, see if that's good on it. We can also check, see if it has pressure, but we'll have to replace the clutch before we can do that. But we can also pull it apart and make sure everything's good inside, and then we can go from there.
Cool. Yeah, let's pull it apart.
All right, so we're going to pull out the clutch hub. Start with that. Unless it's toast inside.
Mike has already taken the what is the clutch housing off, and underneath you can see there's evidence that this got very hot in the past, possibly melted, which means this might not be salvageable.
See right here how the clutch is all melted right here?
Yeah.
That's from the clutch hub engaging and disengaging, and that's from a high pressure problem. So that's the only way they melt like this, so we'll find out more. It's probably gonna be seized up inside, but we're gonna know as soon as we get open.
Okay, right. So probably it's been a part before, hasn't it?
Could have been. Let's pull it apart and let's see how the inside looks.
Yeah. And this little one here, this comes off?
Yep.
And these are little pistons, are they?
Yep. Yeah, it looks all right. They're not seized up. We can check the underside of them, make sure that's good. We're gonna change out the seal right here too. This is one of the case seals.
Yep.
And then there's a couple bearings in here. This is a shaft bearing. And there's also the thrust bearings on the inside.
And we're gonna change those?
Correct.
Comes off, how's
right.
that?
Yeah, the back looks okay. The last thing we're doing is split the case all the way. We're gonna check the pistons, check the cylinder walls, seals inside, so we're gonna have to change those anyways. So once we take this apart, you're gonna have to put it back together because it's gonna fly apart.
Okay, no worries. Whoa, look at that.
That a pistons, are they?
Yep, and everything doesn't look too bad. It's not seized up.
It's complicated, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, that is complicated inside. I can see once it comes apart, no way that's going back together, is it?
Nope.
So we can salvage this. It's just gonna take a little bit of puzzling.
We're gonna pull it apart, put some new thrust bearings in it, reseal it all. Once we get it back together, you'll be in business.
I love the way that works. That shaft with this on there, that acts as a cam that moves those pistons up and down. That's so clever, isn't it?
You got it. And the next thing we're after is the little thrust bearing that's back in the corner right there.
All the way deep inside there.
That's it.
Ooh, good luck.
All right. Might have to tap it out.
Whoa.
Okay.
Now this is a thrust race bearing. There's two of these inside that compressor. One of them's at the top of the shaft, the other one's at the bottom of the shaft. The first one, this one, just fell out. The other one, unfortunately, is buried deep within that housing, and it means that poor Mike here has got to take the whole thing apart to be able to get to that thrust race bearing. And then what he does, somehow we've got to replace them and try and put the whole thing back together. All in the pursuit of saving a few pounds. When you go to your air conditioning compressor guy and he says, yeah, I can do that, but it's gonna cost $300 or $400, and you go, God, that really sounds expensive. Now you know why, because not anyone can do this. Old thrust bearings, boom, over there. Brand new ones out the packet, very nice. So thrust bearing on first, yeah?
Yep.
Washer on after.
There you go.
I never thought I would see that go back together, honestly. Now it's the new clutch that's going to go on top, correct?
Correct. Now we're going to test the coil, and we're looking for a rating between 2 and 5. So now we got 2.9.
Perfect.
So the coil's good. So now we're going to energize the coil to make sure it works. So when I give it power, just suck it in.
Yeah.
And it's working fine. Sucking in just like it's supposed to. There you go. All we gotta do is clean it up for you, give you some new O-rings for the top, and you'll be ready to go.
Lovely. Do you know, I've really enjoyed doing this today because I know we'd saved the original part, and I've managed to save myself over $100 doing it. And I really appreciate your time. Thank you.
Hey, I appreciate you coming in.
Right, well, there you go. Look at that. Our pump started life in the boot of a car. But now it's gonna live on in the front of a car where it's gonna blast chilly ice air over me and Ant. And we certainly need it when the weather's like this. Click here to subscribe.